This is school number one in the capital city, Simferopol, here in Crimea. And the officials here say that the voting has been pretty steady all day. This is one of 1,000 polling places all around Crimea. 1.5 million ballots have been printed, and as you can see, plenty of people turning out. It's a miserable day outside. It's raining, it's dark, it's grey. But it doesn't really matter whether it affects turnout or not. This is a vote without a minimum threshold of voter turnout. So it doesn't matter how many people show up, the vote is still going to count. Now, of course, that's the first step. If the vote goes as expected, and the vote is to join the Russian Federation, with all of these ballots here in this ballot box among those being counted, well, if that vote does go the way everyone expected, it's really just the beginning, because the Russian Duma, the parliament, then has to consider the request to join the Russian Federation. They're going to be doing that a little bit later this week. And as we've seen throughout this crisis, a week is a long time. Anything can happen between now and then. Outside, the voters happy to declare their choice. I'm 45 years old, says this woman, and I never felt Kiev is the capital of my motherland. For me, it was always Moscow. And this, Crimea, always belonged to Russia. I don't think the mess, this trouble, will end soon in Ukraine, so I think it'll be better with Russia. Ukraine was always Russian territory. Ukrainian citizenship was imposed on us, says this woman. And perhaps a marker of the fear of those who oppose this referendum, a Crimean Tatar comes to us, wants to speak, but afraid to show his face. This Crimean government is not legitimate, he says. They took power at the point of a machine gun, and this referendum too is illegitimate. A lonely voice in a city stoked with emotion and nationalist fervour. Michael Holmes, CNN, Simferopol, Ukraine.